been seeing in the business park. I don't want too far into this because, of course, there's planning committee on Wednesday night and there are applications for this area before the committee. But a number of the businesses and some of the sectors have been undergoing some change as well, which has been quite significant. And there have been a number of companies in the area who, for one reason or another, unfortunately not been able to continue to trade. So there are a number of challenges there, but there are significant opportunities. I mean, the access to the World International Business Park from the A41, the link to the waterway, it is strategically important from that point of view. And I think as the economy begins to improve and pick up, we are seeing generally across Europe, this is not just to do with one, but across Europe, we're seeing more people coming along and wanting to talk to us about investment opportunities that create significant employment as well. So I think that's quite encouraging. So there's a range of factors in play in and around Bromborough and other areas, but hopefully the success that we've seen there over the past few years will begin to take up some of those sites that Council of Niblock says have been vacant for a number of years, which they have.
Thanks for that update. Chris?
Thank you. Thanks, Mike. I think it's a really interesting conversation, and I think that there's some very interesting things going on in terms of regeneration in our sub-region. The scheme that I'm starting to know more about is the North Liverpool Beautiful Ideas work, for example, where they're going to, Liverpool is regenerating very, very quickly, but North Liverpool is being left behind a lot. You've got very old dock buildings and stuff like that that people have no interest in at all until very, very recently. So for me, what we're all needs to start being about even more, hopefully, is that is taking, well thought through strategic risks. There's risk in everything we do. There's risks in opening the door and crossing the street. And we have to have that plan in mind. And I think we need the more people that we can get to understand that regeneration isn't just about buildings. It's about people, it's about communities, it's about hope, it's about, so we really need to sort of learn some lessons from just over the water and Warrington, and take points about Warrington as well. I just want to ask a very quick question. You said that European money has gone down to less than 15% than what it was before 2014. I just wondered why, what's the reason behind that? I don't know why that's happened. It's quite shocking.
In the way that European money can be administered, you only have to give a percentage to a company for a project because of state aid, otherwise you distort the marketplace. So for a small company, for example, you can only give them 25% of the project costs. For a medium-sized company, you can give them 15%. And for large companies now, you're not able to support them anymore. So it's about the thresholds for the state aid that you're allowed to. And that's one of the things, when you've got 40% liability gap, but you're going to give somebody 15% of the project costs. Just to illustrate, we've got an issue there as well. So rather than administering grants and everything else, doing something in an innovative way is a must in that situation, for example, to try and bring forward the project in a different way than what we've done previously.
Anybody else? Work program. Are we agreed on that?
Yeah. Chair.
Dog fouling comes under Mark Campbell, which I think might be you and just let you know, but providing the information that you want, it isn't a problem, and obviously it's a key issue that we recognise.
I'd say so, Chair, and I think people will agree with you. Most of our electors would consider dog parks, we don't mention it by
I would agree, John, that that they would, but sometimes it's just with the duties and responsibilities. If we could just check it for you, first of all, and then we'll come back and let everybody know. But providing the information that you're looking for in the debate and discussion that you want, it is not an issue.
Can you also add horse poop? Did I mean?
Yes, we can
add lots of complaints about that.
Thank you very much.